mixed race. My mother is Vietnamese and Chinese, and my father is Caucasian. They met during the Vietnam War. I was born in 1973, here in the United States, Portland, Oregon. I've been incarcerated 18 years now. I've been at OSP since 2004 and have been a member of the Asian Pacific Family Club since then. In 2014, the idea for the garden project came up and we started working on it, and I am the project coordinator and now work full-time on this project. Well, I'll say that the first 14 years of my incarceration were very troubling. I feel like I was lost and hopeless. And for the first 12 years, I never took a class. I refused the opportunities that were there, limited that they are, because I had no hope of ever getting out of prison. And I'm serving two life sentences. And at a certain point, in about 2012, I lost my father. He had a heart attack, and he was my best friend. And I realized that if I was gonna be alone, I had to find a purpose. And so I signed up for a class called Nonviolent Communication that was recommended to me by two friends that were serving life sentences. And I remember them years prior to that class, always getting in fights, always feeling like they needed to prove something. Prison culture breeds that. It makes us feel like we need to be something that we're not. And when they took this class and then sat down with me and told them how it affected them, how it taught them a way of understanding other people's needs and feelings in a way that I was not familiar with at all, they explained the thing called empathy to me, which I hadn't even heard of up till that point. I think it impacted me to a point where I felt like, you know, maybe I didn't know everything. Maybe there was something here that could help me. So I've always been a person that knew that people that I cared about were not things that I took for granted necessarily. Relationships were very important to me. I've always been a very passionate person. So when I took this class, there were several aha moments where I realized that understanding empathy, understanding how to communicate better with people in a compassionate way, could be one of the greatest breakthroughs in my life. And so I took that class, and it changed my life forever. And from the completion of that class, which was a year long, I then started signing up for more classes. I started to realize that there were other things I could do with my time in prison here other than going to the yard, lifting weights, you know. And I found some meaningful purpose to better myself. And I started taking college classes with the University of Oregon, Inside Out. One of the first classes I took was Conflict Resolution, Restorative Justice. And when I took that class, and there was 15 inside students and 15 outside students. It was my first college class ever. And it was one of the greatest experiences of my life. And when I received my transcript from the University of Oregon and I got an A, it was one of the proudest moments as well. For most of my life, I've run from everything. I've never held a job for more than 6 months of my life at a time. Ran away from home a lot as a kid. Spent a lot of time in group homes, foster homes. For the first time in my life, I found a purpose. For the first time in my life, I feel like I'm doing something that's worthwhile and meaningful. And it's one of the greatest honors of my life. And of course, it's unfortunate that I would have to come to prison to do that. But I'm embracing this moment. And I've learned more in the past 4 years working on this project than I've ever learned in my entire life. And I'm just truly grateful for that. In 2014, after spending the last couple years taking classes and trying to better myself, I started to get, when I started to see through a broader lens, I started to care more about my community, and my community being here at OSP. And what I started to do was, people started to come to me when they saw me taking classes and they saw me starting to change and be more positive. Members of the club and guys that I had known for years and had seen me being chaotic in here and you know, kind of in the mix, so to speak, started to see me as someone who might have something meaningful and valuable to say. So guys started to look to me for advice and counsel. So as I fell into that leadership role, I embraced it. And members of the Asian Pacific Family Club executive body approached me about taking over as the new president of the Asian Pacific Family Club. I was reluctant at first. I didn't at that time feel that I was necessarily ready, because I didn't know enough about how the club runs, the challenges of leading a large group of people in that type of format. And so I agreed to come in only if I was to sit by the side of the current president and be his student. And so I started to sit in on meetings and just take notes. And during one of those meetings, the completion of the veterans memorial was done. And I was sitting in a meeting with 11 of the club presidents and myself kind of on a side chair just taking notes. And who else was there, which they meet once a month, was the superintendent of the prison and some of the other administration. The superintendent mentioned how proud he was of the completion of the project, the Memorial Healing Garden, the Veterans Memorial. And he reached out to the rest of the presidents of the clubs and asked them if they had any other ideas for that area. And I think we scribbled a couple notes back and forth to each other quietly while he was speaking and others were speaking about, what about a koi pond? You know, we tried to think of something that we could put in that area that would be represent our culture. And he encouraged me to speak up and ask. And so I asked the superintendent if he would what he thought about a koi pond in that area. And he said, there used to be a koi pond there a long time ago and all the fish got eaten. Would you be able to solve that problem? And I said, well, we can look into it. And he goes, okay, well, do some research and put something together and come back and show me what you got. And that was in early 2014. Of course, at first when we presented the idea, we wanted to present the idea and start building it right away. And we realized that nothing is ever that easy. And so for the past 4 years, I've been fortunate to meet some really amazing people, to partner with some really amazing people. And I've learned more in the past 4 years than I have, as I said, in my entire life. It's been the most meaningful and transformative experience ever. So even if the project were to stop today, I feel like I've gained so much already. So for myself, moving forward, serving my community means a lot to me. I used to just sit around and complain about what I didn't like about prison, what I didn't have. And now I've identified some accountability, and I want to, you know, I feel like this work is restorative, that it is part of my responsibility to restore my community to some type of harmony. And this environment is so sterile and cold and harsh. We're surrounded by concrete and steel. It's what I walk on, it's what I sleep on, it's what I see, it's what I feel. And I feel like that, you know, I understand how that's important in a secured environment, that, you know, that there's also some great value to there being a softer, some softer aspects of the prison. You know, 95% of the people that are incarcerated in this institution are going to go back out into the community. My hope is that they can go back out into the community healthier, mentally, emotionally, physically, and then their reintegration into society in a better state just gives greater potential for them not to come back to prison. The recidivism rates for incarcerated men are so high, and my hope is that we can help through work like this, that it can help reduce that. That's what my hope is. And that while people are here, this natural environment that we're creating will give them a calm, peaceful place to help re-energize their hope, to make them believe that they have a stake in the environment, and that they start making choices on their own. This is a natural opportunity for them to make a choice to you know, make a difference. This project has taught me a lot about humanity, and we've been really fortunate to meet some really amazing people on this journey that have taught me so much and that I'm truly inspired by. And the NACASEC organization, the people at Willamette University, you know, I mean, it means so much that people out there in the world on the other side of these big walls volunteer their time and come in here to help with this project, to believe in us, helps me believe in myself. My name is Johnny Cofer. I'm mixed race, Vietnamese, Chinese, and Caucasian, and I've been incarcerated.